In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
It is Wednesday, the 31st of May, 2023. Eighth week in ordinary time, and the feast of the visitation of the Blessed Virgin Mary. We are recalling the day the Lord visited our homes through our Blessed Virgin Mary, and those homes of ours are in Elizabeth. The welcome that was given by Elizabeth is the welcome we are supposed to give to our Lord every time he visits us. Participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members. Justina Memunato from Freetown, Sierra Leone, text for us the first reading. Beatrice Kamau from Dallas, Texas, United States of America, takes for us the responsorial psalm. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Matthew Tembo, celebrating his birthday today from Lusaka Archdiocese in Zambia. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who, while the Blessed Virgin Mary was carrying your son in her womb, inspired her to visit Elizabeth, grant us, we pray, that faithful to the promptings of the Spirit, we may magnify your greatness with the Virgin Mary at all times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
First reading, the King of Israel, the Lord is in your midst. A reading from the book of the prophet Zephaniah. Zephaniah chapter 3, verses 14 to 18a. Sing aloud, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O Israel. Rejoice and exult with all your heart. O daughter of Jerusalem, the Lord has taken away the judgment against you. He has cast out your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You shall fear evil no more. On that day, it shall be said to Jerusalem, do not fear, O Zion. Let not your hands grow weak. The Lord, your God, is in your midst, a warrior who gives victory. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will renew you in his love. He will exult over you with loud singing as on a day of festival. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, Isaiah 12, 2-3, 4b, c, d, e, 5-6. Response is taken from Isaiah 12, verse 6b. And the response is, great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel. Great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel. Great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel. Behold, God is my salvation. I will trust and will not be afraid. For the Lord God is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation. With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation. Great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel. Give thanks to the Lord, call upon his name, make known his deeds among the nations. Proclaim that his name is exalted, Great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel. Sing praises to the Lord, for he has done gloriously. Let this be known in all the earth. Shout and sing for joy, O inhabitants of Zion. For great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel. Great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel. Great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel. Gospel Acclamation, Luke 1:45. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Blessed are you, O Virgin Mary, who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to you from the Lord. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke chapter 1, verses 39 to 56. In those days, Mary arose and went with haste into the hill country, to the city of Judah, and she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard the greeting of Mary, the child leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit, and he exclaimed with a loud cry, Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why is this granted me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For behold, when the voice of your greeting came to my ears, the child in my womb leapt for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there will be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her from the Lord. And Mary said, My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the low estate of his handmaid. For behold, henceforth all generations will call me blessed, for he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has put down the mighty from their thrones and exalted those of low degree. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, as he spoke to our fathers, to Abraham, and to his posterity forever. And Mary remained with her about 3 months and returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Happy Feast of the Visitation of our Blessed Virgin Mary that concludes for us the month of May. And we see something in this visitation. It is a reminder to take care of our family members. It is a reminder to take Christ to our family members. Mary arose and went with haste to the hill country of Judah. She didn't bother about the distance. She did not bother about the hills she had to climb, but she went because she had to take Christ to her own family member, the cousin. Sometimes we become very lazy. We want to evangelize. We want to show others the Christ we have, but we fail even to forward a message to our family members which has Christ in it. We are quick to share with our cousins all the jokes that we want to share, but when it comes to sharing Christ, we shy away. Mary went boldly to share Christ with her cousin. And one more thing we learn from Mary is that she cares for the aged, for the elderly. Elizabeth was elderly and she stayed with her up to 3 months. 3 months taking care of her cousin. This time we are too busy. The age in which we are is an age where we have no time for each other. Even when we find time to be with each other, we are more on the phones than we are with those people we have gone to visit. It seems social media has kept us too busy such that we have no time to care. We have no time to focus on our families. Mary is teaching us we should spend time. We should spend quality time with our beloved family members. The other thing that we have to understand is that the visit of Mary revealed her as the new Ark of the Covenant. She's the Ark of the Covenant. She's not just an ordinary woman. No, Luke wants to pass this message that Mary is the Ark of the Covenant. In 2 Samuel chapter 6, verse 10 to 11, we read of how the Ark of the Lord, which had been captured by the Philistines, was returned to Israel. And for 3 months, it remained in the house of Obed-Edom. That's exactly what Mary did. She remained for 3 months. Mary, carrying Jesus in her womb, spends 3 months in the house of Zechariah. David, upon hearing that the house of Obed-Edom was blessed because of the presence of the Ark of God, went to bring it with great rejoicing. Upon hearing the voice of Mary's greetings, John the Baptist danced for joy in Elizabeth's womb. What does this teach us about Mary? That at the fullness of time, God sent forth his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as sons and daughters. Galatians chapter 4, verse 4 to 5. For her great yes to God's plan, Mary became a living tabernacle. She became the new Ark of the Covenant, God-bearer, a creature given the privilege of carrying her own creator. What a privilege! I'm jealous of Mary. I'm jealous of this woman. Like Mary, each of us is a bearer of something. Let us examine ourselves. What am I carrying? Does my presence bring joy to others? When I go and visit the Elizabeths of our time, who are burdened, who are going through a lot, do I bring joy or I add more trouble in their lives? I want to say, what do I carry? Do I just carry gossip? Do I just carry hatred? Do I just carry a seed of discrimination and division in the society? Or I carry Christ? Christ that gives hope, the Christ that gives joy to others, the Christ that changes things in the lives of other people. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Wednesday to you, and happy Feast of the Visitation of our Blessed Virgin Mary.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken me, and I Father.